Hello, this is Mr. Horthoren signing off to Darksiders. So, camera controls much smoother now. Yeah. And button props. Oh, yeah. Also stripped of its former strength and powers. Yeah. What the fuck? Okay. Cool. I totally forgot that this was a thing.
The souls of the dead will be your currency. Some enemies are more easily bought than killed.
Cool. There is one thing that I want to note before we get into really anything. The left and right, it starts off with a little bit of a jitter, and it's really fucking weird. Like, it feels like it's trying to smooth things out.
Few can afford his services, but perhaps you can strike a bargain.
The council confers with demons now, does it?
Since the truce was broken, some demons have fallen from the destroyer's favor. Volgrim is one such outcast. He has long sought an audience with us.
How long have I been here?
The fucking council sounds like the precursors, but deeper and even more gravelly. It's like, fuck. Anyways, so, welcome to Earth, shithole. Yeah, pretty bad. I do actually prefer the
second. Looks like our trajectory was a little off. Not so fast, horseman. Let's lay down a few ground rules. Until this is over, you're a dog on a leash. I say bark, you bark. And if I have to kick you, you'd better not bare your teeth. Understand? Or should I teach you to play dead?
It's war.
Good boy.
Yeah, I don't much like that guy. He's probably my least favorite part of this game, from what I remember. God, my brain just shut off for a second. Okay, cool. I remember the controls. Awesome. Oop. There we go. Which button is it? Oh. There we go. I think it. Oop. Not that one, I guess. Now remember, we were beating the shit out of demons and angels at the beginning of this, and now we're fighting zombies. You think they're gonna die in one hit?
Here comes the welcome party. War, why don't you introduce yourself?
That sword is. Oh god, I remember how this controller is. Sorry if you hear any clicking, the X button actually is a lot more firm than it probably should be, considering how old the damn thing is. But it's one of those things that it feels good when you're playing a game to have that response, which I like. But it does mean that it sticks on occasion. Is it that one? There it is. Just relearning the controls. Hi.
Oh yeah.
Oh god damn it. I swear the camera is going to be what kills me in this game. Is it faster? Yeah, probably. Oop. Gauntlet glow. Where's gauntlet interesting ambitions? Oh, cool. Oh, that's just the game's way of letting me know that there's stuff nearby that I can do. Oh. Lovely. Do I jump? Of course, hitting jump works as well. Whoa, you're an explodey dude. Ow. I dodge. I should play DMC Devil May Cry. I played it at party once, because, well, that was the game of choice at the time. And, oh, you're about to explode. And I thought it was amazingly fun. If there's other games like it for PC, I would play the crap out of this. Oh! You can just... Okay. There we go. Oh, I have to hold. I am really glad that I tried that. I was not actually expecting to be able to just straight up grab them and insta-kill them. That's nice. And very gory. Which is nice. Oh, that's a health chest. I should not have picked that up yet. Let's see. Come on. I actually find that hitting the jump button's faster. I think this is just more fun. Like I said, I'm playing on easy, so none of the fights are really going to be all that difficult. Except for the boss fights. The boss fights are still probably going to kick my ass. All things considered. Come on. Are you kidding me? Okay. Let's try this again. Come on. There we go. Seriously. Fucking. Okay, cool. Mindlessly slashing. Point. I wonder if I can use them as the bludgeon. Ooh, I can. Oh, fuck off. Thank you. Oh, cool. Ow. Slice. Warrior is just a brutal motherfucker. Just fucking stabs him in the hand, beats the shit out of him, and then kills him. As if that just... as if just killing him wasn't enough. Get this fucking way. God damn. Shit, dude. Oh, good. I was dashing. That's cool. Wait, that looks like... oh, it's... this game has some serious out-of-bounds. Like, if you... I want everyone that watches this to just pause the video, open up a new tab, and freaking check out what a speedrunner does with this game. Fucking hell. It's brutal how badly they break this game. Oh, lovely. Health chest. And... boss fight? Boss fight. I think. Is it boss fight? Or is it just the first open area of the game?
How long was I gone?
In Earth years? About a century. Long enough for the last of the mouth breathers to die off.
Then... the Third Kingdom is lost.
Yep. Now don't you wish you could just super jump like that in the normal game? That would be so much fun. Death's got some fucking awesome hair.
Subtle. I almost didn't hear you coming.
Volgrim.
The Council finally took me seriously. If so, you're surely not empty-handed. For this shall be the briefest of introductions.
That's a little disconcerting that there's no sound for that.
There were a few young ones. Oh, spectacular. You seek the power behind the one called Destroyer. You will find the answers and the font of his power there. Oh, such haste to die. You aren't even a shadow of your former self. You wouldn't last a heartbeat. Besides, the way to the tower is shrouded by demon magics. Even I do not know the way.
Who does?
Feed my hunger. And I'll feed your curiosity.
And this is the first open world section of the game. It is not fun to deal with because it's... yeah. It is what it is. Let's just put it like that. Okay, so holding down the B button gives me slam. Wait, no. Letting go of the joystick. Oh, lovely. Hi there. I'm gonna throw a card. And again. And again. And because I can, I'm an ass. Ow! And once again, the brutal beating of a demon. Because I care. And this is what I meant about earlier about this being in a semi-open world-esque game. It tries to be an open world, but at the same time, a linear story. And it, for what they tried, it worked out decently. But for the type of game this is, it, in my experience, it didn't work quite as well. Because this has a very, I don't want to say Dark Souls, but that's kind of the vibe I get when I play this game. It's very Dark Souls with a lot, without the customization, I guess. Fuck you. Actually. Ooh. B to descend. Yes. Come on. There we go. Soldier. Legion of the House of the End Days. Return to Volgrim and he will reward you. Oh. Okay. How do I go up? Oh, it's Y. Okay. I think that was the only thing. Did I get... Okay, I was stuck for a second. But we're cool now. So this first section, you're really just supposed to find a couple treasures to help you get used to, I guess, the mechanics of the game. But the way it's done, just, it's boring. I don't know another way of saying it, but it's boring. I mean, I'm certain it's fun to some people, but this part is basically just kill some more, and pick up some souls. There's not a lot to it. But yeah, like I said, with the speedrun route, you actually skip this entire section. You don't even... I think you get to skip Volgrim, even? I'm not entirely sure. I'm probably wrong. It's been a while since I watched the speedrun of this game. Awesome. Okay, well... there's another treasure chest up here. However, I don't know how to get to it, so I'm not going to worry about it. Well, I might have to worry about it, actually. I can't remember if you actually need to get all the treasure chests, or if you can get most of them. Bloody mist. Let's just keep bashing skulls. Oh, lovely. I think this should end up blocking. Whoops. This game is very obviously meant to be played with the combat being handled with the fucking this thing, the lock-on function, because otherwise it's actually quite difficult to control. Oh. You could just kill all the enemies and grab a couple of chests. You don't need all of them, but you do for later on in the game. Because I believe that they're used also as your upgrade currency.
We have enough souls to feed Volgrim's hunger. Now, maybe he'll feed our curiosity.
Well, we're gonna sort of... Oh, okay. this is not good. Ow. Come on. Oh, no. Spike. Punch. Punch. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And there we go. I think that's just a faster way of killing. It's not really a requirement to. I know it's a requirement to kill some enemies a little later on, but yeah. We're gonna feed Volgrim and we're gonna call it a day.
These ancient gates have a mind of their own, but with this, you may reach an understanding. Beyond the gate, seek out Samael's prison. Once, Samael was close in power to the Dark Prince himself. Some might even say, a threat. You will find he is no friend to the Destroyer. Seek me out when you've gathered more souls. I will make it worth your while.
And now we can open up these gate motherfuckers. Oh. How do I use it? Earth Core. Press RT to activate the horn when equipped. Oh, it has to be equipped. Okay. So, this thing actually can disrupt enemies as well. I'm not right trigger. What? Oh, there we go. And there we go.
My ancestors awakened at last from the dreamless sleep. Then we are free.
None are free while the Destroyer still breathes.
The Destroyer, yes. To his service we are bound, though enemies we remain. So his enemies, we call friend.
Big
pass now, friend. Most bring victory. Most bring freedom.
I actually forget what he does after this. I think he wanders over here.
Yes, that was the gate. I can't wait to find out what's behind it.
Farewell.
Oh, he goes to a spot we can't get to yet. Right. That's old dunk. Anyways, well, we unlocked the gate, and yeah. I think.
Greetings.
Fuck off, Volgrim. I think we're gonna call it a day.
Farewell.
So yeah, if you enjoyed this, then be sure to let me know. Leave a like, favorite, subscribe, do all the good shit. Mr. Horthoren, signing off.